בעזרת השם, חוק לישראל, פרשת וישלח, יום ראשון, Sunday, the peace about the Gemara peace. So, here we have Gemara Brachot, Daf Nun Gimel, Misha Achal. The Mishnah is telling us that if a person ate and he forgot to do bracha, Bet Shammai holds that you need to go back to the place where you ate and then you need to do the bracha. Bet Hillel Omrim, Bet Hillel holds that Yivarech Makom Shenizkar, you can do the bracha wherever you are, you don't need to go back where you ate. Amar Rav Zvid, Vitem Rav Dimi Baraba, Machloket B'Shachach. This Machloket Bet Shammai Bet Hillel is only in a case where he forgot to do the bracha. Aval B'Mezid, if the person ate and he knew that he needs to do Birkat HaMazon and he still got up and he left the place, so Divar Kol Yachzor Limkomo Yivarech, according to everybody, even Bet Shammai, either Bet Hillel, he needs to go back to the place where he ate to do the bracha. Pshita, the Gemara is asking, this is simple, v'shachach nan. The Mishnah clearly says that in case he forgot, so it has to be that only forgot, but if he didn't purpose, he needs to come back. Why is answering, how would I think, even though when he does in purpose? Why the Katani v'shachach? But why is the Mishnah telling me v'shachach? L'odiyacha kochan de Bet Shammai, kamashmalan, to teach us the strength of Bet Shammai, the chidush of Bet Shammai, that they hold that even shachach, even though he forgot, he needs to come back. They are more machmir. So that's why Mishnah says shachach. But really, this is the same halacha, even though it's mezid. So I would have think that if it's including mezid, kamashmalan, no, that when Mishnah says shachach, it's only shachach, only if he forgot, but if it's mezid, he doesn't need to, if it's mezid, if according to everybody, he needs to go back. Tanya Mula Bet Hillel Bet Shammai. Now the Gemara is going to bring a brayta that will explore these two opinions. Bet Hillel told Bet Shammai, L'divrachem, according to you, that we need to go back, Mi she'achal b'rosh ha'bira v'shachach v'yarad v'lo birech, yachzor l'rosh ha'bira v'yivarech. If a person ate all the way up in the very tall tower and he forgot to do bracha over there, and he came, and now he's already done all the way down, and he yachzor l'rosh ha'bira v'yivarech, does he have to go back all the way up there to do the bracha? Amru lahen Bet Shammai le'Bet Hillel. So Bet Shammai answer Bet Hillel, what do you mean? What do you mean? מי ששכח ארנקי בראש הבירה לא יעלה ויתעלנה? If a person ate, he forgot his wallet all the way up to in this tower, the same tower that you're saying that you should not go down, should not go up, back up, if he forgot his wallet, you're going to tell me that he's not going to go back all the way up to pick up his wallet? לכבוד עצמו הוא עולה. If for his own purpose, his own kavod, he goes up the tower to the tower, lechvod shamayim lekol sheken, in honor of Hashem to make the bracha over there, kol sheken, it's even more that he should go back to the place where he ate. Anu te talmide, Gemara brings a story about two talmide chachamim, two students, chad avid b'shogeg kevet shamay, one of them happened to be that he forgot to do the bracha, and he still went back to do the bracha at the place where he ate, like Bet Shammai says to do. And he found a wallet full of gold. And one left the place in purpose, and he did Birkat HaMazon in purpose, and he still did not go back to his place, like Bet Hillel hold in Shogeg. V'ach le'aria, and a lion ate him up. Rav Bachana v'kazi b'shayata. Rav Bachana was going with shayara, means like when you go through the desert with a lot of people, so when you go with a lot of people, it was dangerous to stay by himself. He need to be with everybody. Achal, he ate, ve'ishteli ve'lo barich, and he forgot, and he didn't do the bracha. Now we said in the Mishnah that according to Bet Hillel, which is halacha, it doesn't have to go back to the place where he ate because he forgot. But still, Amar, Rav Bachana said, Echi Avid, how should I do that? Yamin alu in shay levarech. If I tell them I forgot to do bracha, Amri li barech. Acha, say the bracha here, like we said, like Bet Hillel. And what's the reasoning of Bet Hillel? Kol echad mevarchat lerachamana mevarchat. Because wherever you are and you're blessing Hashem, you're blessing Hashem. Hashem gets a blessing from every place, so you don't need to go back. Mutav de'amina, mutav de'amina lehu. It's better if I tell them in shay yona de'dava. I forgot a bird of gold, made of gold. And then this way they're gonna let me go. They're all gonna come back with me to bring this bird of gold. Amalu intuoli, wait for me. The insha yonadidava, because I forgot this golden bird. Azil ubarich, he went and he did the bracha. Ve'ashkach yonadidava, and Hashem made a miracle that he will find a golden bird at the place where he did the bracha to reward him for this. The fact that he came back. Umayishna Yona, so the Gemara still asks, why did Rabbi Abba Bachana decided to say that he forgot a golden bird? He could have said anything else. Why Dafka, a bird? The Mitili Knesset Israel Yona, the answer is because Knesset Israel, the Am Israel, the Shechina, is compared to a bird, to a dove. Dichtiv Kanfei Yona, נחפה בכסף, ועברותיה בירקק חרוץ. This pasuk talk about the Knesset Israel, the Shekhinah, and he called it a bird. מה יונה אינה ניצולת אלא בכנפיה, אף ישראל אינה ניצולים אלא במצוות. How do we know that this pasuk talk about Knesset Israel? Because the pasuk says that the bird protects herself with her wings. So the dove, in the same way that Am Yisrael also protects themselves only with the mitzvot, so the Yonah also protects herself with her wings, and this is the connection between Knesset Israel and the dove, and that's why we know that this pasuk is talking about Knesset Israel, and this is the reason why Rav Abba Chana chose to say a golden dove. Yaakovach. Here.